Please state your name for the folks at home.
I'm Jay Lee.
Jay, eh?
Yeah.
Good name for late night.
Thanks.
Where are you from, Jay Lee?
I'm from Saratoga, California.
Saratoga, California.
Saratoga, California.
That's where they have the sparkling water.
I did learn about that in my AP US history class, yeah. It's, like, there was this big contention.
Let it go, kid, let it go. Anyway. Word on the YouTubes and the face tweets is that, you know how to gang them pretty good.
I can Gangnam pretty good, yeah.
What did you say?
Gangnam. Korea number one.
Yeah. I'm thinking there's gonna be a dance-off. You ready?
I'm ready.
Ferguson, sponsored by Progressive. Visit progressive.com today. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
I didn't know it would cause such a riot. I was very concerned. It made me laugh. I can just come over here a minute. There's a lady over here, a lovely lady in a red jacket. And you looked like you were going to hurt yourself. So here. Here you are. No, I was genuinely worried. I saw the candy and you were like, oh, get over. I was like, no. Welcome to Los Angeles, California. Welcome to the Late Late Show. I'm your host, TV's Craig Ferguson. There you are. Boom. I gave out some candy. It's a great day for America, everybody. Yeah. Anyway, it's Friday, everybody. Hooray! No, I'm actually very excited today because the big movie Cloud Atlas is coming out today, although I'm not sure what a Cloud Atlas is. But it'll be good because Tom Hanks is in it and he plays six characters. Sometimes I get intimidated with too many characters in a movie. I like the plot of my movie simple. A hero, a villain, both wearing nothing but a bra and panties. Maybe a woman there as well, you know, for romantic interest. You got a picture of one of the Tom Hanks characters from Cloud Atlas. There you are, that's it. Now, see the crazy thing about that? Is that that's Tom's real hair. Right. That's his real hair. He's actually been wearing a curly wig for 25 years. I also wear a curly wig. Not in my head. And my penis looks like Tom Hanks. No, it doesn't. I wish my penis looked like Tom Hanks. I'd be, well, I don't know. I'd let it be in movies, I
guess. Yeah, well, you could name it after his character in Toy Story.
Hey! Anyway, look, it doesn't. Look, the Cloud Atlas movie, here's the idea. What the premise of the movie is, the past determines our present, and our present predicts our future. And I'm like, what? I wish I'd known that before I took my first tablet of acid when I was 16 years old. I said tablet of acid, which sounds like not as cool as saying a tab of acid. Either way, it's not a good thing. It's just not a good idea. But if I could go back to the 16-year-old me, you know, taking that acid, then I'd be like, don't ruin this. You know, don't ruin your mind like this. And the 16-year-old me would be like, oh, Liza Minnelli. And I'd be like, really? You see my penis, it looks like Tom Hanks. Anyway, I'm going to see Cloud Atlas this weekend because Tom Hanks is on the show on Monday, and I'm going to ask him about his other movies. You know, the one where he spent the whole movie talking to that deflated leathery ball. Meg Ryan. Ah, it's a joke! It's a joke! It's a joke! Come on, leave me alone. It was a joke. I love Meg Ryan. I love her. Please don't think I'm having a celebrity feud with Meg Ryan. I'm not. I adore Meg Ryan. She's had a little work done, but she still... No, she still looks great. You got a picture of Meg Ryan? No, come on! That is not Meg Ryan. Do not do that. I'm going to get in trouble. A real picture of Meg Ryan. There she is. No! It's a joke. I love Meg Ryan. Who doesn't love Meg Ryan? Al-Qaeda. And even then, they're like, no, we can't like Meg Ryan too, actually. So, death to America, except Katie Couric and Meg Ryan. These are the two. Anyway, I'm talking about Tom Hanks. You know, looking back at his movies, I see a pattern. In Toy Story, he played the cowboy. Saving Private Ryan, he played the soldier. Castaway, he played the shirtless, hairy dude. If he can play a Native American, he will have achieved something called the Village People Grand Slam. The whole set. Here's what I found out about Tom Hanks. His movies have made a fortune, in total, $4 billion at the box office. To give you an idea of how much that is, take the movies I've made, their box office, and add $4 billion. Actually, that's not true. How to Train Your Dragon made $500 million. Brave made $500 million. And then the others, there's about 140 bucks in there, so... But a billion. How much do you get of that $1 billion, Craig? I'm still here, haven't I? Are you saying you get nothing? Yes. Not nothing. I'm looking at you, Disney. We can cut that out. Anyway, Tom Hanks. Yeah, Tom Hanks is also a director. He's did that movie, you know, that thing you do. You remember that thing you do?
Oh, it was great, yeah.
I loved that thing movie. But I wasn't talking about that thing
I thought you meant that thing that you do.
What thing?
You know, man.
No, I'm talking about it was a movie about the one-hit wonder band from the 60s. I still remember the song. And not the words, it's just like you do the thing you do, la 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 da shoo, la da do, honey boo boo, the thing you do.
Yeah,
honey boo boo. Big hit all over the world, that movie. Huge hit, hit.
Kids loved it.
It got translated into different languages, Jeff, probably German, it would be. What else? They translated it into Australian. Translated it into Australian.
Yeah.
That thing you do. Anything else?
That sounded like your Willie Nelson. That was
really... That's the weird thing. When I try and sound like Willie Nelson, I sound like an Australian.
It's uncanny.
I know, it's weird. You know how I've been doing this thing where I think that I was maybe going to try and be the Prime Minister of Australia?
Yeah, yeah.
What if Willie Nelson wanted to be the Prime Minister of Australia? He could probably do it. They'd be like, it's Willie Nelson.
Yeah.
He's a genuine star.
I want to be the Prime Minister of Australia.
There you are. What is that?
Yeah, sure, yeah.
You're watching The Late Late Show with future Prime Minister of Australia, Craig Ferguson, where it's a good day for America, mate.
Good night.
If there's one thing I learned when I was president, it's this. There is no greater pleasure than sitting in the Lincoln bedroom watching NASCAR while eating a whole rotisserie chicken. And by NASCAR, I mean two chicks getting it on.
Back to the show where I am still smarting from being served. I got served by Jay Lee, who is my... How do you say it, Jay? Gangnam.
Gangnam.
Yeah, so...
What did he say? Did he say condom? What the hell was
yeah,
that?
Yeah, yeah. What you do is you put a condom on, but you put a condom on that's too small for you. This is going to be a problem for you. But the... an undercurrent of ooh there. Did you feel it?
No, it's fine. I don't even have a penis.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. That's why it's going to be a problem for you. But what you do is you put on, that's how you get the Gangnam style, right? Because you put on a condom, it's too small, and you're like, ah, ah, ah. Right, Jeff?
Sure, yeah.
What do you mean sure like that? What do you mean sure
like
that?
Well, I'm imagining it would restrict the blood flow. I'm not sure what's happening down there, but...
You're not being very supportive. There's been something wrong with you this past like week or so.
What are you talking about, man?
You know what I'm talking about.
I really don't know what you're talking about.
I think you do know what I'm talking about.
It's Katie Couric, man.
Yeah, it's Katie Couric. Yeah. It's the Katie Couric thing. You think it's real. It's not real. I love Katie Couric. I can't say enough good things about Katie Couric. There.
No, I talked to her just yesterday, man. It's not looking good.
Why is she mad?
She's worked up, man.
Well, why is she mad at me? What did I do?
Well, it's this whole Prime Minister of Australia thing.
Because I had a dream I was the Prime Minister of Australia, now Katie Couric hates me?
Yeah, yeah, that's about the short of it.
That's showbiz. Greg, that doesn't make any sense. Oh, really? And the caramba! Dancing horse does? All right, what time is it, Jeffrey Pearson?
It's tweet mail time. Time to take advice from a man whose junk looks so much like Tom Hanks, his name for sex is When Harry Met Sally.
Hey, you know, or When Harry Met Harry, whatever, man.
Yeah.
I'm European. Did you just go, oh, there, like, did you hear that? Like a shotgun of, oh? You have no idea. All right, you want to do a jingle?
Yeah, let's do it, yeah.
Emails and tweets. This is from Sean in New Hope, out there somewhere. Dear Craig and Jeff, or Jeff and Craig, my partner and I are expecting twins, and I want to name them Jeff and Craig. Any way I can talk him into it? I don't think you should, man.
No, no. It's a horrible idea.
There's only one Jeff and Craig, and that's us. Right, Jeff?
That's right, man.
Jeff, squint at the camera, but handsome-wise. There you go. This is from Larry in Pennsylvania. Now, I know you're going to be upset, Jeff, because Larry's a flamingo. And we hate flamingos. Jeff and I hate flamingos. Why, Jeff?
We abhor them because they urinate on themselves.
They urinate on themselves. Also, we went to a club once called the Flamingo, and it wasn't that good, was it?
It was terrible.
Because when we walk into a club, normally, what do the ladies say when we walk into a club? They say,
Here come the players. They're so fine.
But we walked into the Flamingo, and everyone just peed on their legs.
Yeah, and normally I'm into that, but it was flamingos. Very upset.
Yeah, that's right. I forgot to read out the question.
Thank you.
And no matter, this is from Jacqueline in Salt Lake City, who says, Dear Craig and Jeff, both of our kids just told us they won't... this is too long. This is from Neil in Melbourne, which is in Australia! I'm going to practice. G'day, my fellow Australians. I know you're probably thinking, crikey, this bloke's accent sounds a bit dodgy. Well, that's because I'm upset. I think things could be better in Australia, and so does my lovely wife, Jeff, right?
I completely agree.
Wait a minute, that bloke sounds like Willie Nelson. Quick, vote for them. Dear Craig and Jeff, next Australian Prime Minister elections are in 2013. I know. This is from Brian in Kentucky, stroke Nashville. He's in two places. See that?
Oh, that's crazy, man.
Yeah, well, he's a bird. He can get around. Says, Dear Craig, dude, you're demented. At least I only live in one place. Tootsie Frootsie. This is from Cynthia in Burbank, California. You ever been there?
Oh, I love beautiful.
That's great over there, isn't it? Burbank?
Beautiful. Oh, yeah.
When I do the Tonight Show, I'm going to do it from Burbank.
Crikey!
Why not? Throw your hat in the ring. Dear Craig and Jeff, I'm having a disagreement with my husband. How many times per week is normal for a married couple to have sex? None. It depends. You know, it depends how old you are, what kind of shape you're in, how many kids you've got, you know, if you've got a basement. I don't know. What do you think, Jeff?
A basement?
Yeah. You know, for where to put the swing and the equipment.
Is that when you lower the bucket down and tell them to put the lotion in it? Is that what's the pill? I'm just wondering. Yeah.
Yeah, but I've got a new thing. I do it in an Australian accent.
Yeah,
I'm like, put the lotion in the basket. It wraps the lotion on its skin. Or it gets the hose again.
Or it gets the hose again.
I think we damaged our campaign in Australia there, Jeff.
No, I think you're going to be fine, man. 2013.
2013?
Yeah.
Peterson Ferguson for Australia for a bright new Down Under. We're right back, everybody. We're right back. This is a fantastic and beautiful actress. She guest stars on The Good Wife. It shares on Sundays on CBS. Please welcome the adorable Amanda Peet. Oh, Amanda!
I like your new dig.
You like it here?
Yeah.
It looks pretty nice, doesn't it?
So far, it's going okay.
Yeah. We got a fire blazing in the grate and our rhino, and we still got the gay robot skeleton. It's all working.
Did you enjoy my husband as much as he enjoyed you?
If I had a nickel for every time I'd been asked that. Your husband, David Benioff, was here last week. Yeah. Yeah, no, he was here last week. He's fantastic. He's a really talented writer, you know.
Sorry, I...
Now, let's get that straight. You don't think he's a talented writer, or you got a hair in your mouth?
The latter, not the former.
Right, you had a hair in your mouth. Yeah. Because you were like, I said, he's a really talented writer, and you went...
No, yes.
You got hair in your face.
Yes.
What's going on with your hair?
I don't know.
It's good. It's unruly and sexy.
Unruly.
Unruly. It's unruly
it's
and sexy.
Unruly.
No, it's nice.
Do you just hate it when people do that? When they're
what,
like,
my
it's
accent?
Unruly.
No, I like it, actually. It makes me feel like I'm at home.
Really?
Yeah,
that's a huge compliment to me.
Yeah, it's like whenever you go to other countries, you should always speak English in the accent that you think they sound like when they speak English. And they love it. Like, if you go to Paris and go, hello, I'm from America. They're like, aw, this is great.
Never hey, works for me.
So, listen, your husband was here. He was very, very nice. Tall, good looking, and a genius. I actually don't care for him.
I lucked out.
Yeah.
Well, he cares for you.
No, he's,
great
he's
deal.
Very, very,
There's
very talented.
There's a whole bromance.
Man.
I mean, he knows everything about you. He's That's... like, did you know he was in a band? He was in a band with
You didn't know I was in a band? I sent you tons of letters about me being in a band. I was like, dear Amanda, please don't get married to David. I was in a band.
But then there was the restraining order.
Yeah,
so
no, these were bad times. But now you're on the Good Wife on CBS. Is it good? Do you play a lawyer or somebody that goes nuts and shoots up the joint?
I just can't take you seriously with the mug. When you drink, it almost gouges out your eyeball. Look.
I like to live dangerously. I think I may do the rest of the interview talking like this.
All right, then.
Hey, do you want to talk like this?
I do, indeed.
Are you a fan of Downton Abbey?
I like the first season quite a lot, and the second season I
totally agree.
Oh, good.
Yes.
Yes, but...
Now, the second season, they kind of lost it a bit. They went for the, you know... the soap opera feel, as about the first season. It was great, apart from one thing, when the Turkish guy died for no reason. I'm like, no reason? Like, he just went to bed and then died? Like, he didn't even cough.
Weren't they knocking boots?
Yeah, they were knocking boots, but that's not, you know, you don't die just for having... Oh, well, it was Victorian times. Yeah. Actually, it was Edwardian, to be fair. It's just to stop me getting letters, you know. Do you like the period dramas, do you?
Yes, I do. I mean, no one will give me one, but I wish I could be in one.
But what about Game of Thrones? You could be in Game of Thrones. It's not really, but it's fantasy
kind
of thing.
I've been sleeping with him for 6 years.
Yeah, he's the showrunner of that. You guys have you got two kids?
It's because I won't take my clothes off.
How did you get the two kids? Oh, you won't take your clothes off on the show.
Yes, no, yes.
Well, not everybody takes their clothes off on the show.
Well,
Mark Addy didn't take his clothes off on that
true.
Show.
He
In
didn't,
fact,
I don't
thank
think.
Thank goodness.
He, yeah.
I love Mark Addy. I've known him for a long time.
Really? He's
not
a great
really,
guy.
I just think he's nice.
I can't keep up with you. I'm like, oh, shoot.
Yeah. Are you living in Belfast then?
We live in Belfast, and speaking of boobs.
Happy to go there. Tell me about your boobs. You want to talk about your boobs? All right.
No, I just, when you live in Belfast, it's very hard to find a small bra.
Oh, yes. Yeah. No, Irish girls. Yeah. Yeah. No, Irish girls have got great racks.
The way you said that was way too knowledgeable.
Well, you know, I like Irish women and I wear bras. So. I have no idea what you're talking about. What are you talking about?
Oh, no, I just, it's hard to find a small bra in Belfast. In the
you need
city.
A small bra? You look like regular size bra to me.
That's what I think.
Right.
But then I go to the store and they're all absolutely enormous. I mean, just.
I think I gotta get over there, really. Really, is that true?
Yes, I have to go to the teenage section. In order to get a bra when I live there. This story's going really well. And also, it was apropos of nothing.
But you kind of painted me into a corner right there. Like, anywhere I go is going to be creepy and weird. It's like, there's nowhere for me to go except creepy and weird.
Teeing it up for you.
You don't do it like that. I just got ooed again. Have you ever been to Australia? I'm thinking of running for Prime Minister, but I don't know if they like me.
No.
The Australians, nah, they're pretty mad at me.
Why are they mad at you?
Oh, I said some things.
What? The Katie Couric thing?
She's not Australian, is she?
No, but I just...
Anyway, there's no Katie Couric thing. It's not a real thing.
Well...
Did you talk to her? Is she mad at me?
Well...
Why is she mad at me?
I have no...
You ever been to Australia?
No.
You should go. It's a really beautiful country and one that I hope to lead in forward.
I'd vote for you in a heartbeat.
Yeah, but you're not Australian. That's not going to help me.
It's a good point.
And also, I don't really know if I want to be I just had a dream. You ever had a dream you just can't shake the thought? That's what it is. I had this dream that I was the Prime Minister of Australia, and I just can't shake it. I thought, you know, if things had gone different, maybe I could have been.
Are you not enjoying this?
Yeah, I just thought it may have been different. You know, I mean, look, I could be the Prime Minister of Australia going, gee, I wish I was a late-night douche in America. The grass is always greener, you know that. So the good wife, come on, talk about it. You're on it, what do you do?
Sal, I'm with Juliana Margulies, who I adore.
Oh yeah, showbiz, fine. What do you do on the show?
What's wrong with that? No, can't we talk about Jules?
You're having a feud, aren't you? You'll be next. You having a feud. No, she's lovely, Juliana Margulies.
Yes.
Yeah, very nice.
Yes.
But what do you do in the show?
We're friends, and I don't know what I'm allowed to say. I'm a military lawyer, and we get involved. And
do you wear an outfit? Do you wear a little outfit?
Yeah.
Yeah, we got somewhere to go. What about, where'd you get your bra for this outfit? Yeah.
It's CBS. They made me wear a poof-up bra.
They do the same to me. We're out of time. Do you want some fruit?
Thank God.
Oh, come on.
I'm just tanked.
What are you talking about?
My husband is better at talk shows now than I am.
That is insane, you just said. That is insane.
I'm going to be in a feud with my husband because green with envy about how brilliant he is.
You know how you can tell when a couple are having a feud and they're really in trouble?
How?
Celebrity at-home piece for a magazine. Things are great. When they say things are great, yeah, don't ever do that, because then people will be like, whoa, ooh.
I don't think we'll do that, no.
No, don't do that. I would never do that. Would you ever do that?
I don't think so.
No, that's not allowed.
Why invite that kind of...
attention?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Bad childhood.
Did you have a good childhood? I mean, we're out of time, so quickly, very succinctly, how was it?
Fantastic,
good. All right. Do you want a piece of fruit here? I mean, a lot of this stuff's been here since your husband was here last week, so. Now, he passed on the midget pineapple, but I thought you might like it. No, okay. A lot of pineapple haters around your house then.
Why do you have such weird fruit?
It's me. What kind of fruit do you want? Apples, oranges.
What is this, like a metaphor for your personality?
Well, this...
I said personality! I mean, come on.
It's
you
too small.
Selected
too
this.
Small. It's too small. I did not. What, you think I went and chose the fruit? Like, you think I go like, ooh, I've got a late night show tonight, better go fruit shopping? I don't do that.
No, I think
I'm a fruit guy. I'm a guy.
And he's like, this could be funny. Some dumb actress is gonna make some innuendo.
We can only hope.
Baby, I'm tanking.
You're not tanking. You're doing great. In fact, it's so good that it's over.
I choose this.
Then you're done. Amanda Peet, everybody, wherever. I was just thinking about doing something. I'll get to it later. I was just thinking I might make a change over here. Once I get back from Australia. My next guest is a very talented actor. He stars in a new show, Go On, which is on Tuesday nights on NBC. Take a look at this. John Cho, everybody, John Cho. John. How lovely to see you.
Nice to see you.
I'm always very impressed when I meet someone who initially became successful for playing someone very, very stoned. And then not stoned at all.
Not at all, no.
Well, no, it makes you seem much more together than maybe you actually are.
That's the weed handicap.
So the people still expect you to be a little bit bombed all the time?
Yes, I'm always feeling like I'm disappointing people by not being stoned.
No, on the contrary, I'm impressed.
Oh, you are?
Yeah, yeah. Wow, he's really got his act together, man. He was like, he's like, his tie's done up. He's cool.
His tie's done up.
But you've moved away from that now, of course. You play the boss in this show.
I play the boss in this show. It's called Go On. It stars the... What's his name from Friends?
Oh, yeah, that guy. He's good, that guy.
Yeah, he's
Matthew
very funny.
Perry.
Matthew Perry.
Yeah. He famously played a friend. And I'm always surprised when I meet him that he's not actually my friend. Do you ever get, I mean, like, you're a professional actor. You work in Hollywood all the time, right?
Yeah.
Do you still, because I still do this, I still confuse people with roles, particularly if it's been an iconic role. You've done that with Harold Kumar.
Right.
And the guy from Silence of the Lambs, I'm like, I can't get past it. Ted Levine, can't get past it.
You're afraid he'll rip
Yeah,
his
and he's up. Like, yeah. I'm a little lost in the basket. Yeah. I can't get past it. Do you ever get that?
I do, and I have that same problem, and I always think that I've met people when I haven't I've taken in their performances so deeply.
You mean you've watched them on TV?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's an interesting verb. Yeah. Watched.
Watched them.
Yeah. It's simple. Yeah. It's clean.
Taking
it's
in their performances. Nice though. Are you a very classically trained actor? Did you go to...
Not at all. No, I really fell into... I just fell into it. I was an English major in college, and... I was in a writing group with a guy, and he said, how tall are you and what do you weigh? Apparently there was an actor that had fallen sick and wanted to know if I fit the costume, and that's kind of how I fell into
that. That's how show business works. No, this is true. I got this job because the guy before me was also called Craig, and they figured they could just like... put a Craig guy in and everything will be fine. No one will notice.
Yeah.
Where did you go to college?
UC Berkeley.
Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah. I was the dumbest one there.
No. Yeah. English major, that's good.
Yeah.
What did you read? What brought you to it? What are your the classics, perhaps?
The classics, Shakespeare? Yes. I wasn't that well-versed in Shakespeare, and I still remain woefully ignorant of Shakespeare. But what did I guess, you know, my favorite authors were Czechs, Kundera.
Kafka?
Yeah. So
not a lot of laughs in Kafka, I've got to say. I mean, the guy turns into a beetle. That was pretty funny. And then I'm like, where's he going with this? Stays with the beetle the whole time. I'm like, he turns into a beetle, and then I thought maybe it's going to be like a Jim Carrey movie. He's a lawyer. He's trying to get it together, but he's a beetle. But
this is you got a lot of Czech material.
Yeah. You know, you don't do a lot of Kafka at the Chuckle Hut, my friend. So when someone brings up they like the Czech authors, that's where I go.
Oh, this is the man that did the Nazi, but the Hitler bit. So this is
who did?
You did.
When? I used to have a character called Bing Hitler. Yeah. It was. I was trying to get two names that juxtaposed each other. Bing, lovely, friendly. Hitler, not so much.
Well done. Well done, amigo.
Yeah. Do you ever, amigo?
Amigo. Yes.
I didn't know you were of Spanish extraction. Have you ever been to Mexico?
To Tijuana, yes, for amphetamines.
Okay, what did you do when you were in Tijuana?
I got very lost.
Morally?
Yeah. for 15 minutes tops.
Yeah, that's all you want to be lost for. Are you a traveler? Do you go around a lot?
No, not really. This is exceptionally boring chat show material, but...
Fit right in with me, buddy.
No, you know, I've traveled mostly through work. That's probably the best thing about our
That's
profession.
That's a good thing about being an actor. Yeah, you go around, see stuff, have sex with the locals, and leave. I'm kidding. You don't have sex with the locals. You have sex with your castmates. Actors
yes, sir.
Are like, yeah. We're out of time. You want a piece of fruit?
Sure.
Or we could do an awkward pause or one of those things.
Fruit me.
What are we going for? Something, there's new grapes been added since the commercial break.
I'll take the heaviest fruit.
Well, I don't know that a coconut's really a fruit. Is a coconut a fruit? I think a coconut, is a fruit? I thought it was a nut.
It's a fruit and a weapon, no?
What? And also it can be a bra. You cut it in half, you make a fortune getting the smaller ladies in Belfast. They, Apparently all the women in Belfast, have you ever been to Belfast? Amanda said all the women in Belfast have enormous racks.
Really?
Yeah, I know. I'm like, why am I not there?
I gotta work in Belfast.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
I love
grapes?
Sure.
Thank you. Yeah, I didn't want to get anything weird.
It's my Korean guy right there. It's my buddy.
Yeah, yeah. That's Jay. He was doing the thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We all know each other.
Yeah, it's like me. I know Shrek and Billy Connolly. We all know each other. It's like, it's a thing. I get it. Anyway, we're out of time. So, well done on the
Thank
food.
Thank you, George. Right, bye, guys.
If you're going to be in the L.A. area and would like to attend a taping of The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, please give us a call at 323-570-0059.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Craig?
Of course, if I became Prime Minister of Australia, I would never allow cats to throw boomerangs at little beautiful mice.
Very good.
Oh, hello, young lady. What's your name?
My name's Jill.
Where are you from, Jill?
I'm from Queensland, Australia.
And you, sir, what's your name?
I'm David, and I'm from Queensland, Australia.
Oh, Jill and David from Queensland. See, it's working. They're beginning to come.
It's unbelievable.
Do you guys know who's the Prime Minister of Australia right now?
A redhead lady called Julia Gillard.
Yeah, any good?
No.
So, who else is good down there at the Prime Ministering? Anybody right now?
At the Prime Ministering right now, I reckon you would be the better one.
Well, I don't know. I don't know. Would you guys embrace the idea of an American immigrant and his gay robot pal as to run your country?
Crikey, that would be just ripper. Absolutely.
Wait.
What did she say? She said that would be awesome.
Ah. Thank you very much indeed.
Well.
Your accent's very good too, I meant to say that. Your accent's really good. Really good, mate.
I didn't understand that. What did she say?
She says your accent's really good.
Oh, right.
And when you go to Australia and you're Prime Minister, the women are Sheilas and they're the blokes. Right. So mate's the thing, but if you have another Australian up here, you say, you're a ripper Sheila, mate. You got all that?
This is getting a little more complicated now, first of all. But I'll do me best dinkum dingy dingy out. Say goodnight, my Australian friend.
Goodnight!